Dave. He's the new guy on our shift, so we're gonna have him get dressed for you here in a little bit. But why don't we start off with some fire safety things? How about that?
Yeah.
All right. Awesome. We'll save some questions till the end, okay?
Okay.
So if you guys see a fire in your house, or if you see somebody that's really really sick, or if you see a car accident, does anybody know what number you call on the phone?
Yeah.
What number do you call?
One.
All right.
We hadn't gotten it.
Interesting guesses. So when you
99.
Yes. Is it two?
Damien, Damien. Nobody should be talking right now except the firefighters.
So when you guys see an emergency like that, you pick up the phone and you call 911. Can you guys repeat that back? 911? A little louder. Let's try again. 911.
911.
Very good. So we call 911 for emergencies, but only for emergencies. If you're hungry and you want a pizza, do you call 911?
No,
I don't call that. If you're trying to get a hold of your mom because you're mad at your dad or something, do you call 911?
No.
No, you don't do that. Nope. You just call 911 for emergencies. So if your house is on fire or somebody's very, very sick or hurt, or if you see a car accident, things like that, okay? Let's say you hear your smoke detector beeping. Does everybody have smoke detectors in their house?
Yes.
Yeah. Have you ever heard them go off?
Oh,
yeah, well, if it's going off, it means that there might be a fire. There's at least some smoke in your house.
But at my home, there was fire.
There was fire? That's no good. So anyways, the smoke detectors are going to beep very, very loud. It's nothing to be afraid of. It just means that there's some smoke and that you might want to try and get out of your house. So if you open your door to your bedroom and you see smoke, how do you want to go? Do you want to just go running straight up through the smoke, or maybe since smoke goes up,
Mommy,
you want to crawl underneath the smoke, right?
No.
You want to crawl. You want to stay low and go. Crawl out under the smoke, right?
And also, I want to touch the fire.
Well, you don't want to touch the fire. You want to go away from the fire. If you open your door and there's too much smoke, close your door. Go over to your window. You can open your window or bang on your window and wave when you see the firefighters and say, I'm over here. I need help. We'll come and help you. So you want to stay low and go. Sound good?
Stay low and go.
Yeah.
Everybody
okay.
Say that. Stay low and go.
Okay. So here's another thing. When you guys are in the car, does everybody here wear their seatbelt and sit in a booster seat maybe?
Yeah.
That's good. If you don't, you might want to ask your parents about that and make sure that you do all of the proper safety things. You want to wear your seatbelt in the car and make sure that you're in the right booster seat. Your parents can help you with that, okay?
Mm-hmm.
You want to make sure you're safe if you get in a car accident.
But I told my mom, can I be in
the
booster? And she said no.
Huh. you might want to ask her again.
I don't want it to be in the booster.
Well, we want you to be safe, though. So, have you guys done a fire drill at school before?
Yes.
Yeah.
Yeah? And you guys have a meeting spot outside, right?
Mm-hmm.
Do you guys have a meeting spot for at home if you have to do a fire drill at home?
Yeah.
If you don't, talk to your parents about it. Maybe it could be the mailbox, or it could be the tree, or if you have a close neighbor's house, you guys could all meet there, and that would be a perfect spot to meet up. Sound good?
Yeah.
Okay. So, if you're in your house, we don't want you to go hide if there's a fire. We want you to kind of make yourself known. You want to yell out for help, especially when you hear firefighters. So we're going to have Dave here get dressed up in his stuff, and we're going to show you what it looks like and what it sounds like when he's in all of his gear, so you guys kind of know what to expect. And it's still just Dave when he's dressed up in all of his stuff. Again, nothing to be afraid of. You can see he's just like you and us, just in his regular old clothes and everything. But he'll just sound a little bit different and look a little bit different when he's all dressed up. So, we'll just kind of go one step at a time, all right? So you're gonna take his radio off so he doesn't accidentally press buttons and start talking. So he's gonna start, he has his hood here. He puts that on because that protects his ears and his neck and his hair and everything. And then he's gonna step into his boots. You see he kicked his shoes off already. His pants are already over top of his boots, then he can just go 1, 2, 3, pull his pants up. Now he's got his feet covered, and he's got his legs covered, he's got his hips covered, and he has some suspenders to keep his pants up. So what else isn't covered yet? His arms, tummy, back. So he's got his coat here. He's going to throw his coat on. His coat's pretty heavy. Imagine wearing a winter coat, but imagine wearing a winter coat in the middle of the summer. It gets pretty hot and all this stuff, but it's a lot heavier. So he's going to make sure he clips all of his clips and puts all of his Velcro together to make sure he's safe. And then pull his head back. So now he has what's called his SCBA here. It's kind of like a backpack like you guys might have for your books, except it has a tank on here full of air. It's the same air that we breathe right now. And he'll turn it on. You'll hear it kind of go brrr, beep, beep, beep. That's just it turning on, letting us know that it's ready to go. Hear that? So that means it's ready. So now he's going to swing this around and put it on his back. He's going to get all of his straps tight and make sure that he's ready to go into the fire, to come put the fire out and save you guys, okay? So he's got waist straps, same as like a seatbelt buckle, and he tightens everything up. So what's still exposed on him? Hands, face, ears, neck, hair, all of that. Okay, so what he's going to do next, he's going to put this mask on his face. He's not going to be breathing the air yet. He's just going to put the mask on while he finishes the rest of the process here. So he puts his mask on. Still Dave, you can still see his eyes. You just can't really see his mouth or his nose anymore. So that covers his face, and then he's going to pull his hood back up and over, and that'll cover back up his ears and his neck and all that stuff. Now, if something were to fall, it might hurt a little bit, right? So what does he have right there?
Fire hat.
It's a helmet, fire helmet. So he's going to put that on, and that'll protect his head in case something falls down. So now he's protected, right? What else is still uncovered?
His hands.
His hands. So he's got special gloves here. Like an oven mitt, but a little bit heavier and a little bit more like finger holes in it. So he puts those on. Now he's just about ready to go in. The last thing he needs to do is start breathing the air off his tank. So listen to the sound that it makes when he starts breathing. Still Dave. He's just breathing out of here. Same thing, right? No big deal. So if you hear that noise crawling through and we're crawling out, fire department, you want to say, help, I'm over here. Can we scream that?
Oh.
Say, help, I'm over here.
Help.
Yeah. So it's still just Dave. He just sounds a little different. It looks a little different. Does anybody want to come up and shake his hand?
Yeah.
High five.
High five. There you go. Good job, guys. See? Awesome. Very good.
Oh.